JP and I are here with our awesome new Spanish teacher, Cristina Flores. Say hola.
Hola.
She has already helped us so much, and she is going to help us even more because we have the opportunity to interview a famous artist here in Ecuador and throughout all of South America. Can you tell us his name in Espanol? I know it's Patricio. Mm-hmm. And the name of his exposition, please.
Of course. We are here with Patricio Palomeque in his exhibition called Lo que pasa cuando no pasa nada. And it will be translated What Happens When Nothing Happens.
I like it. She says his name much nicer than I do. So now let's meet Patricio. Patricio, how did you become an artist? We would love to hear your story.
Sí, mi trabajo desde niño fue problemas de comunicación. Tengo algunas traumas, no sé, y creo que el arte siempre fue una opción para poderme comunicar de mejor manera, ¿no? Entonces opté por desde muy joven por seguir una carrera que tenga que ver con las artes plásticas, ¿no?
Since I was a child, it had very hard time to adapt to anything, so I just realized that in the art I felt like I was doing well. So that's why I decided to take a career that it would be related with arts.
We love your work. We are so impressed. What was your inspiration for your exposition?
Sí, mis temas de trabajo desde hace algunos años es la ciudad y mi intención es interactuar, desdoblar, interactuar la ciudad en esta exposición. No, mi mirada no está centrada solamente al paisaje de la ciudad, sino tiene que ver un poco con la historia, con las historias de los territorios, ¿no? Que es un poco diferente a paisaje y territorio. Entonces, mis trabajos siempre, de alguna forma, dialogan con estas historias, estos territorios. Básicamente, la ley, el motif de mi obra de los últimos 10 años, más o menos.
My work is always being related with the city, and in this case I wanted to interact and make some conversations between not just the landscape of the city, but the stories and the history around. So the leitmotif of my play, it's been always the city and these kind of conversations and dialogues between these two things.
And what kind of mediums do you work with, and which is your favorite?
Sí, yo vengo de la pintura básicamente, pero igual en los últimos años mi trabajo tiene que ver tanto, mis narrativas tienen que ver con el videoarte, con la fotografía, con instalaciones y cada vez con participación con otros creadores que pueden ser músicos, cineastas, escritores. Me interesa siempre estar dialogando con diferentes procesos técnicos, pero también procesos personales de otros artistas.
Well, I started with painting, but then I realized that I like to have a more extensive work, like using some other instruments, like video art, reading, also painting, and then I always wanted to be related with some other expressions and some other artists who make works with cinema and reading, some other things like that, because I think that helped me to express better what I want to say.
This is JP's favorite painting behind me. Patricio, can you explain the meaning for us, please?
Sí, esta es una obra justamente que tiene una participación de un joven artista urbano que se llama Jonathan Mosquera. Inicialmente esta obra es de 2016. Es un nocturno urbano de la ciudad de Cuenca, al cual yo invito a este artista urbano a que él pueda intervenir para darle un carácter más poderoso y que tenga un diálogo con la ciudad. El significado de esta obra tiene que ver el borrador, que es muy famoso, la marca Pelícano, que su simbología, por sus colores, un poco habla del poder, del poder como tal. Es una síntesis de la bandera china como de la bandera norteamericana. hablando justamente del poder capitalista. El joven artista urbano es un artista que trabaja con estos elementos políticos, simbólicos.
This is a play that I worked individually in 2016 at first, and then I invited an urban artist to make an intervention in this play. And basically what I'm trying to do with this is to talk about the power that some countries have. So I am using in here an eraser brand that it's called Pelicano, because it is a very powerful and very known brand in here. So I thought that could represent also the flags from China and the States in some ways. So that's the representation of this power and how we work these things in a context of a city, in an urban context. So this intervention, it was made by a young artist, an urban artist called Jonathan Mosquera, who is also from Cuenca, and an intervention, basically, it is the work of an artist work over another artist's work.
Can you tell us more about the significance of the eraser, the colors, and the star in the painting?
Sí, el artista urbano Jonathan Mosquera, en todas sus intervenciones, él siempre utiliza a manera de una síntesis, de un muy simbólicamente, los colores de las grandes economías mundiales, ¿no? Porque él siempre está criticando al capitalismo como tal. Y de alguna forma China y Estados Unidos son las más potencias del que mueven el capital en el mundo, y él siempre apela a esto. Pero exactamente esta intervención, este graffiti, asomó en el pasado, en las últimas, en el mes de marzo, las últimas elecciones, como utilizando el borrador como un elemento de anular los procesos electorales que siempre están atravesados por partidismos, por corrupción, y esta sería el significado exacto del borrador, ¿no?
This artist, Jonathan Mosquera, he always likes to work with political and some criticism against the capitalism. So he used these colors and the star because he wanted to represent the huge power in the economy that these countries like China and the States have over other countries. But specifically in this case, he wanted to represent with this huge eraser the way we have been eliminating our votes for the elections that we had in Ecuador a few months ago. So that was the meaning for this specifically play.
And what is the significance of the U and the arrow pointing to the U?
Sí, el artista urbano Jonathan Mosquera utiliza como su firma de artista urbano, de grafitero, yo, con el sentido de dejar al otro, pasar al otro la problemática que él está afrontando, ¿no? En este caso el borrador, toda la negación lo pone en el otro, o sea, siempre él quiere estar como anónimo de alguna forma en esa representación, es un poco la razón de su firma.
Jonathan Mosquera, this urban artist, always signs his place with you, and that it means actually a criticism for everybody. He wants to put in everybody else the responsibility for the problems he is letting us know about. So that's the principal thing about his signature. So you also have this significant of an anonymous person. He wants to be anonymous, but also with that meaning that everybody, we all have the same problems and we have to confront them.
Can you explain the series of photos?
Esta obra se llama El desengaño llegó luego. Es una obra que habla un poco sobre una historia personal, que es como armar mi propio Big Bang, ¿sí? Comienzo En esta obra no utilizo dispositivos como la cámara fotográfica, sino un escáner, la cámara del celular. Lo que utilizo es algodón de azúcar para crear esta atmósfera que parece una nube. La historia personal nace que en mi infancia mi madre por primera vez me hizo probar el algodón de azúcar y el algodón de azúcar me dijo que era una nube. Entonces la idea de... yo me creí que era una nube. Con el tiempo me costó, mientras crecía, entender que no era una nube, sino era una simple golosina. A partir de esa historia personal, armo esta obra, El desengaño llegó luego, para un poco comprender los procesos que implican entrar a la madurez y a entender el mundo de otra forma.
This play is called The Disappointment Came Later. And it is basically something that I talked about my days when I was a child. And I didn't use the camera as a resource. I actually used a scanner to do this. And then the meaning behind all these photographs, it is that when I was a child, my mother gave me sugar candy. And she told me that it was a cloud. So I always thought that that was a cloud and I was eating a cloud actually. But then when I was growing up, it costed me a lot to realize that it wasn't a cloud, but just a candy. So it is a representation of what happens when we grow up and the things that we have to deal with while we're growing up and thinking some things differently and realizing that it means different things probably.
It's very powerful. Wow. We really like this piece of art here, the sculpture. Can you explain the meaning, please?
Sí, esta obra se llama Árbol Dentro. También parte de una historia personal. Es un árbol de pera que formó parte del jardín de mis abuelos. Yo comí de sus peras y luego se cayó de viejo el árbol hace unos 6 años más o menos, y yo guardé el árbol porque me parecía interesante. No tenía la idea que iba a hacer con él, y apenas hace unos meses comenzó a armarse la idea. Y está constituido de cobre, está unido por una varilla de cobre, elementos de cobre que simbolizan un poco nuestra riqueza, entre comillas, riqueza de minera, que está básicamente todo nuestro suelo lleno de cobre, entendiendo que el cobre es aislante, transmisor. Entonces es una obra que igual apela y habla de lo filial, de la familia, de las tradiciones, del territorio como tal.
This work is called Tree Inside, and this has also a personal meaning, and it is made with a tree, that it was a pear tree, that it was in my grandparents' garden, and it fell because it was very old, like 6 years ago, so I had that tree just saved because I knew I wanted to do something with that. So this represents the traditions and the union with the families. And it is made with copper, this resource that isolate things and also could transmit energy. So that has to do a lot of with the expressions we have with family and the union between that.
And I understand that the video and the picture are related to Árbol Dentro.
Sí, entonces yo hablaba que el cobre es un transmisor de energía que está utilizada para atraer los rayos, las tormentas eléctricas. Entonces la obra dialoga con este pequeño vídeo y esta fotografía. El video es dos vídeos superpuestos. El un vídeo es una persona que está cruzando el puente, y el otro vídeo es una filmación de una tormenta eléctrica. Quiero que no exista una edición, sino un montaje para que esta suma de la energía con el puente se transmita. La foto de lado es una foto tomada por mí en en el 2010 en Puerto Madre, que está en Tierras del Fuego, en la Patagonia, en la parte más austral del continente, y muestra la imagen de un bosque que está caído por una tormenta eléctrica. Es todo un bosque. Entonces, la obra intenta dialogar sobre esa carga muy telúrica y esa zona de tormentas, como un poco simplificando que nosotros venimos y estamos en la adversidad. O sea, somos una cultura que está formada desde esas connotaciones, ¿no?
Well, in this case we have a photography and a video, and in the video we have a man walking through a bridge, and then we have a thunderstorm. And this is related with the structure we just talked before, because it is also this presence of the copper that have this capability to isolate and get the lightnings and the electric storms. But then also this bridge has a very important significance in all this exhibition, because it connects all the place we will see in here.
We're sad that this exhibition is closing tomorrow. We're really enjoying it. Are you moving to another location or are you starting something new?
Luego de esta exposición, algunas obras van a el video, viajan, se van a Europa. Parte de estas obras van a ser expuestas en el mes de febrero en Quito, y alguna otra obra, otra serie, se va a una exposición de fotografía a Colombia, y entonces sí, algunas se mueven a algunos lados, pero no va la exposición completa a moverse, sino diferentes piezas.
Well, some of the pieces of this exhibition will be moving to some other countries. The video will be in Europe, and then the photographies will be in Colombia. So some of these exhibitions will travel around, but not all the exhibit as complete work. And there will be some of these also in Quito in February.
Thank you so much for taking the time to speak with us. Muchas, muchas gracias. I learned so much. I really enjoyed this. And thank you for translating.
No,
really
pues yo encantado, y no, gracias a ustedes por la posibilidad de hablar.
Well, I'm so glad. So thank you very much for the possibility to talk about this.
We were really excited to have the opportunity to talk to Patricio about his artwork. He's so passionate about it and so talented. And I did want to remind you that his full speech that he gave at the art exhibit opening will be in the blog post. And I also took a bunch of pictures of his artwork that came out really cool. Yeah. So go check those out. And I'll put the link to our blog in the description below.
Yeah, I thoroughly enjoyed our time with him and really getting to delve deep into the meaning of the pieces.
Yeah, it was neat to hear his
perspective. It was a great opportunity, yeah.
Mm-hmm. It was.
Yeah, and we're excited because we know we'll have more of these type of events coming up that we will be able to share with you.
Mm-hmm. All right, is that it for today?
I think that's it for today.
Awesome. Thank you guys for watching.
Yes,
let us know if you have any questions. And if you need to get in touch with Patricio or want to buy any of his artwork, we'll put the link to his website in our blog post as well.
Yes, and if you liked this video, please give us a like.
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up. All right. Ciao.
Ciao.